Welcome to our instructions for Form I-983. Form I-983 is the formal training plan that is required when applying for the STEM Optional Practical Training Extension. In this discussion, we're going to be talking about the form itself, reviewing some major issues or questions that students commonly have, as well as just some general information about the form and reporting. Form I-983 is a form that's put together by study in the States. And so this form is not the greatest form. It is, you know, a little clunky, but it is always important to make sure that you're using the most recent form. I have not seen an update to this form in the past, but it is always helpful to make sure that you're using the links in the ISSS portal to make sure that you're at the most current version of this form. Now, this form is not on USCIS's website. It lives on Study in the States, but it is a form that we, as your sponsor, while you're on OPT and STEM OPT, that we maintain on file. And in 2019, this form, SEVP, has required us to start uploading this to CVIS. So it's important that, one, it's completed, it's filled out accurately, and that you are following the terms of this form throughout the 24-month process. Now, you know, you're going to want to make sure you fill this form out accurately and fully. The pages of this, pages 1 through 4, you're going to fill out. There's sections that are completed by the student, there's sections that are completed by the employer, there's sections that you're going to work together on, some sections might need to be completed by HR, and then there's the evaluation sections that are completed during the evaluation periods. So in short, get to know this form and work with your employer if you're requesting that STEM OPT extension. So like I said, Study in the States manages this form. And we are going to upload it to your CVIS account when you provide that initial request. So anytime we have a new employer that's going to be a STEM extension employer, we upload that original request. Then students who are authorized to participate in that STEM extension have to report to the Office of Global Engagement every 6 months. It doesn't mean that you have to fill out the Form I-983 every 6 months. You only have to complete that Form I-983 if nothing has changed. You're doing the evaluation on the 12-month and the 24-month reporting. However, if you do have any changes, say you change employers, or they change your position with a certain employer, or some aspect of the training plan is no longer important, or maybe they've changed gears, you should be completing a new I-983 training plan with your employer that accurately reflects what you're doing and how they're monitoring you throughout that process. You can find information for both you and the employer on studyinthestates.dhs.gov. Again, this is where they're going to store current forms. They have great instructions, and there's information for employee resources. Say your employer is not sure how to fill out the form, or they have questions about the responsibilities. Study in the States is your resource. When you're completing Form I-983, again, this 5-page document wants to know how your job with your employer is related to your STEM field. Remember, if you're not in a STEM field, you're not able to apply for a STEM extension, and you are limited to the 12-month OPT. I call that the standard OPT. So when you're going to do this, again, you're still sponsored by Utah State University, and so we are required by law to make sure that what you have provided to us makes sense and meets the terms that make the STEM extension so valuable. This documentation also supports when government and other entities have questions about the value that our students on STEM extension provide. Because what you're doing in the field is important and is great, make sure that it's clearly documented on this form. So again, making sure that you have current forms, even if the form is outdated, making sure that you're clicking on the links to make sure that you have the most accurate forms. USCIS has some information about the I-983 instructions, as well as the study in the states. We're going to go to those resources just to show you a little bit around here shortly. Remember that you're, you know, supposed to maintain proper signatures, handwritten signatures when possible, and that you're, you know, really thinking about these questions and answering them fully. All your responses should be visible, and we should be able to see them when you submit them. So if you send us some great documentation about your STEM training plan with your employer, but we can't see it, we're going to ask you to resend that. So we're going to go to the Study in the States website. The Study in the States website has what's called their OPT Hub. And so if you go to their homepage and you type in the STEM OPT Hub or you type in I-983, you will likely end up on this page. This page has information, again, over here on the right, you will see for students, for schools, for employers, additional resources, information about that extension, the CIP codes. So if you're not sure if your major is eligible for STEM, you can look at those items on this website. Very, very helpful page, and something that, you know, is a good first stop. On this page is both the Form I-983 link and the Form I-983 instructions. The Form I-983 is a form fillable. I recommend that you filling it out online, though you can fill it out also by hand. It's much easier when we're trying to review it if it's legible. So I'd recommend that you save this to your desktop and keep it on file if you need to refer back to it. When you do your evaluations, depending on how you did those signatures, you might have to fill those out by hand, but at least the core document you can fill out online. So we'll talk about each of these areas. Again, I mentioned there's sections to be filled out by you as the student, as well as the employer. And then we get into not only the employer, but your supervisor and identifying clear student roles, your goals and objectives, how your employer is going to oversee your position and oversight, and how they're going to measure and assess what it is that you're doing for that employer during the time period of your STEM OPT. On the Study in the States website, you can also find these training plan for STEM students OPT. It breaks it down by section. So if you have questions about what do they mean by student name, DSO, school code, all of those can be answered by utilizing these instructions. So I would say fill out the form, and then when you have specific questions that you can't answer, I would link on those questions and go straight to the section that applies to what you're curious about. The Study in the States website is a great resource for you to get a lot of commonly asked questions, but as you know, things happen in the world and things change. If you're applying during some COVID period, you might find that if there's any kind of shelter in place, that it may be difficult for you to get signatures. You know, generally we're gonna request those signatures, but you are able to do e-signatures on the form I-983, unlike the form I-765. Some acceptable e-signatures include using like Adobe DocuSign signatures, Apple Pen signatures, and of course, handwritten signatures, you know, that can be scanned and pasted into the signature field. We cannot accept any forms where your name has been just simply typed into the signature line. So regardless of what's going on in the world, make sure that your signature is something that's legible and meets these requirements. We're going to go through some very specific items on the Form I-983 just to touch on some of the things that are commonly asked. So when we look at sections 1 and 2, the student's going to complete that section. Most of the information that you're going to be looking for can be found on your I-20 or your USU transcript. When it asks for the SEVIS school code for Utah State University, that's where you're going to provide the DEN number. Again, that number can also be found on your I-20. When we look at your student SEVIS number, that is the N00 number that's listed on your I-20. And then you can list the DSO who is your primary advisor for the Office of Global Engagement and who's going to be reviewing this document as the designated school official. When we're looking at your STEM OPT requested period, that start date is going to be the day after your standard 12-month OPT ends and for the 24-month period that is covered. So make sure that you include those dates. Now, your job. Often we get asked who is supposed to be signing these forms. There are questions that are in sections 3 that might be something that only human resources can answer. So it is a good idea that your employer reach out to human resources for your particular company and determine either those answers and if they would rather have your supervisor sign that or if it is something that they need to sign. It asks on Form I-983 that that person have the ability to sign on behalf of the company. Now, reminders, to apply for that STEM OPT extension, this employer must use E-Verify and have an E-Verify number that they're going to provide to you to include in your I-765 form. If they do not have an E-Verify number for your I-765 form, there is no point to continue with the I-983. At that juncture, you want to look for another job. I have had students who get to the 90-day period before their 12-month EAD card ends and have to find new work because they find out late in the process that their employer not only does not use E-Verify, but is not willing to apply for it. In addition to using E-Verify, you have to be working a minimum of 20 hours for that employer a week. STEM OPT does not allow you to be working less than 20 hours, and that position also must be paid. So while you're on that standard 12-month OPT, you might be working full-time or part-time, paid or unpaid. If you're applying for the STEM OPT extension, you must be paid, working 20 hours, and you should be receiving a compensation that is comparable to other positions in the field. So you and your supervisor will work together to complete Section 5. Again, this is identifying your responsibilities, the goals, what's going to happen, and how they're going to oversee and have oversight on this 24-month period. Then the employer will complete Section 6. Now, it is the employer's responsibility to understand what they're signing off on when they complete this Form I-983. They're agreeing and acknowledging that they will actually monitor you, and if there's need to update this form, then they will work with you to update this form and make changes to that training plan. They should be conducting periodic evaluations of your work. So that way, if there is something that needs to be adjusted or improved on Form I-983, it is the responsibility of both the employee and the employer to notify your DSO, which is your primary immigration advisor, of any changes or deviations to this plan. You should never look at Form I-983 and be like, well, it's close enough. It should accurately represent what it is that you're doing for this company in the STEM field. Similarly, with every process, once you complete the Form I-983 as part of applying for your STEM OPT extension, you are going to log into our portal and upload this document. Again, when you're filling out this form, plan on 3 to 5 days in order for you to get that I-20. This doesn't include any mailing times, and it doesn't include any issues if for some reason that form is incomplete. Most delays in processing are due to failure for a complete form, or after you've logged into the portal, you've completed the process, but you never hit submit. Make sure that all of the requirements in the ISSS portal are completed and that you submit by clicking the blue submit button at the top of that record. Again, making sure that your address, email, and phone are up to date in your MyUSU because that information feeds over to CVIS. You wanna make sure that that form I-983 form is signed by you and the employer. We will not accept a blank form and that will delay you getting your I-20. Make sure that you have a copy of your employment offer letter and your previous EAD. Everything else is going to be very similar to your process when you requested the standard OPT. But these additions are important, as well as making sure that you have a copy of your degree. So in order to complete that ISSS portal request, make sure you have everything. And if you have questions, start early. Make an appointment with an advisor or a peer advisor if you have questions on processes. If it's something about timeline or immigration, make an appointment with your primary advisor. Now, we do need to stress the importance of the annual evaluations. The annual evaluations is what can be found on the final page of the form I-983. Now, we requested that you submitted pages 1 through 4 completed when you applied for your STEM OPT request. And then we request that you provide updates, but you must complete the 12-month and 24-month evaluations. These are your own kind of evaluation about your progress. And so if you're sending that in, you'll be in status. These evaluations should be submitted no later than 10 days following the conclusion of your reporting period. So again, because you're sponsored by Utah State University, all updates should be reported within 10 days of any change, or in this case, 10 days of that deadline. You can submit it early, but you need to submit it in time. Not reporting those evaluations on Form I-983 can jeopardize your students' non-immigrant status, especially now that these updates are put into the CVIS portal. CVIS, Study in the States, USCIS, expects that if they're giving you a benefit to work, that you are doing due diligence to provide what it is that you're doing and how that process went. Again, this is part of you agreeing to the terms of requesting work authorization for that 24-month extension. So if you have any questions, please make an appointment with your primary immigration advisor by visiting the Global Engagement website and or reaching out to our peer advisor if you have questions about our forms. We look forward to seeing you in the near future online.